Whether you're a professional welder looking to broaden your horizons, or a complete beginner looking to understand the basics of welding, or even a welding instructor seeking unique educational content for your students, this video was created specially for you. As a supplement to our welding white paper, Common Welding Methods and the Use of Laser Illumination in Welding Imaging, this video consists of four main parts. Introduction, welding processes, imaging techniques, and objects of imaging. Part 3, imaging techniques. The imaging of welding process is challenging due to the brightness of the electric arc, blinding the camera. To achieve the best results and visualize the welding process clearly, there are a variety of methods with their own consideration. Section 1. General guidelines for capturing high-quality images of welding processes. A. Filtering and illumination. One way to image welding processes is to use the process light as the only light source for the camera, without the inclusion of active lighting. In this case, the illumination is mainly provided by the electric arc of the welding process, the temperature of which varies between 6,000 and 20,000 degrees Celsius, depending on the process. The problem with only relying on the process light is that it is often too bright for the camera sensor, which results in saturated images that do not reveal much about the process. One measure to decrease the bright light is to use neutral density filters, but that just means that the dark areas become much darker. To visualize both the hot and the cold regions at the same time, narrow band pass filters can be used, which block specific wavelengths of the process light, resulting in much better images. When you use an active laser illumination with the bandpass filter, you get the best possible results. B. Camera and optic properties. In industrial environments, the continuous real-time monitoring of welding processes is often desirable, which means that low frame rates are used. On the other hand, in research and development, it is often possible to use a high-speed camera to record the welding process, allowing you to capture fast phenomena, which might be missed with a regular camera using lower frame rates. Regardless of the frame rate, the camera should preferably have a short exposure time, and a monochrome sensor if it is to be used with laser illumination. Equally crucial is the illumination of the process with a short laser pulse, preferably on the microsecond scale, instead of a continuous wavelength source, for example. The main criteria for selecting camera optics include the field of view and the working distance. Adjustable iris is often useful, as it makes it possible to adjust the overall image brightness. Additionally, a smaller iris enables a larger depth of view. C. Positioning of the camera and illumination. By modifying the relative angle between the camera and illumination, different features of the welding process can be highlighted. Additionally, the positioning of the camera and the illumination also play a role in avoiding specular reflections from the metal surfaces of the workpiece. Common visualization geometrics include 1. The camera and the illumination are pointed at the same process from essentially the same direction. The surface of the workpiece and the wire, among other things, can be seen clearly. Specular reflections, however, might cause disturbances in the image. 2. Side illumination. The angle between the camera and the illumination is around 90 degrees. The setup often reduces specular reflections and can improve the visibility of the melt pool. 3. Direct back illumination. the object is between the camera and the illumination. This setup generates sharp silhouette images, which is suitable for drop formation studies, for instance. Four, indirect diffused back illumination. The illumination is not directed directly at the camera. This setup improves the visibility of the melt pool in comparison to the direct back illumination. Five, application of diffusing elements or multiple illumination sources. Distributed illumination, like light delivery via multiple illumination fibers. This setup reduces the amount of specular reflections. 6. Combination of techniques described earlier. Section 2. Machine vision versus high-speed imaging. Machine vision refers to the continuous monitoring of industrial processes with camera-based solutions. In welding processes, machine vision can be utilized in process and quality control. The process parameters can be adjusted on the basis of the live image or results generated by image analysis. Machine vision, combined with advanced image analysis algorithms, enables automated process control and thus decrease the workload of staff. High-speed imaging is defined as the capturing of multiple consecutive frames at a fast rate. In the welding industry, it is mainly used for research and development purposes. High-speed imaging makes it possible to see fast and ultra-fast phenomena in slow motion, which means that they can be analyzed carefully and their inner workings understood. A combination of machine vision and high-speed imaging can also be utilized in the monitoring of industrial welding processes. The analysis software can be programmed to trigger high-speed imaging when the algorithms detect a certain change or feature in the process that might be of interest for further analysis. Section 3. Laser illumination. The main benefit of laser illumination in the visualization of welding processes is that it enables the use of a highly efficient narrow bandpass filter. Lasers provide monochromatic, speckle-free light and high irradiance. As a companion to the laser illumination, filters are a powerful tool for manipulating the amount and type of light entering the camera sensor. This is crucial, especially in GMAW and GT8W, where the electric arc is very bright. Depending on the setup and the availability of additional components, the filters that can be used include, for example, neutral density and narrow bandpass filters. Other benefits of laser illumination in the visualization of welding processes include clear view through heat, possibility of high-speed imaging, eliminating motion blur, high-quality images that enable simultaneous image analysis and live monitoring, for example, dimension, shape, position, topography, and surface defects, possibility of measurements over long distances, polarized light, linear or circular. For especially fast phenomena, such as shockwaves, laser illuminations provide the possibility of using double pulses, which makes it possible to capture expansion speed of the shockwave. Section 4. Schlieren and Shadowgraphy. Schlieren imaging is used to study phenomena that are not necessarily visible to the naked eye, but that have the ability to change the direction of the light. The technique is based on visualizing differences in the refractive indices of transparent media, such as air or water. Shadowgraphy is a visualization method in which images are captured with the same setup as Schlieren images, but without a mask. The Shadowgraph technique produces shadowgrams, which is not a focus optical image, but a mere shadow. Shadowgraphy is less sensitive than Schlieren, but it is suitable for the visualization of shock waves and turbulent flows. The two techniques can complement each other in terms of information they give about a phenomena. While shadowgraphy displays changes in density, it does not show direction. We hope that you enjoyed this video and you learned something new about welding. By liking, commenting, subscribing, and sharing this video on your social media, it will make it easier for us to decide if we should make more similar content in the future. For more information, please visit our website, cavitar.com.